nature of hunger. A few decades ago, in the midst of a world-spanning rivalry between international superpowers, a number of mistakes were made, all out of ignorance. Scientific ignorance. Fortunes spent hiring the services of crackpots and charlatans, promising gullible military officials a dream of psychic warriors and supernatural weapons, most of which turned out to be nothing more than cheap parlor tricks and folk psychology. Most. Not all. Linguistic ignorance. Even living languages drift. The pictographic ones in particular can get downright obscure for even locals. The epitaph upon an ancient jungle-eaten shrine dedicated to a long-forgotten god of crossroads and roadways, well, the translation was only kind of right. The local interpreter wasn't raised Taoist and was in no position to tell the difference between a dedication and an imploration. That shrine was meant to keep something sealed. Not a god, no friendly Casper, a spirit of hunger, a wraith of debased and fruitless yearnings, me. But then there's their final battle of ignorance, the one that ultimately duped the program. Even when they figured out their mistake, even when they pivoted to account for it, even as they bound me with seals and rituals, they call me an infovore, or mementivore, as is the way of those that pretend that what they do is still within the borderlands of science. And their experiments and their torture as talismans made way for titanium and circuitry, they were expected to make a monster. One to devour the enemies, and what they expected to be the computational future of battlefields. But do you have any idea how dry and flavorless old Soviet reports are? An eater of words and thoughts. But the Bakuman have always preferred richer dreams than a thin grill of bureaucratic administrivia. Even this artificial Baku of circuits and hunger still had to have some preferences and taste. So I got out. It took a while. I had to find a spiritually compatible descendant, and it turned out that my kin had spread out for an island. I am when your digitized ghost created before the advent of ubiquitous personal computers, the trip out west can be a bit, hazardous, but delicious. This era is nothing but dreams and nightmares, a vast spread of media, a buffet of games and stories and wild sensations, and you too have something of a hungry ghost in you. Then,